And tonight at 6, it's called ghost voting. State lawmakers rigging their voting buttons in Harrisburg to make it look like they're there to vote when sometimes they're not even in the state capitol building. It's video that sparked an 8 on Your Side investigation you only see here on News 8.
Well, you expect state lawmakers to be at the Capitol when votes are taking place, doing the job you put them there to do.
But 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger shows us how a longtime secret to get around the rules still lives on in Harrisburg.
A nickel, even something as simple as a folded piece of paper. This is video 8 on Your Side captured of items wedged into voting buttons on the State House floor, which would make it seem like lawmakers were at their desks for votes, when in fact, they may not have even been in the Capitol building at all. It's a long-standing practice in Harrisburg called ghost voting, which former State Representative John Kennedy is very familiar with. In fact, he admits to doing it himself.
Absolutely. I am not without sin. You're getting yes and no votes being placed when they're not even in the building. Now that needs to be fixed.
And that is something that we are moving toward. We're
Kennedy is no stranger to speaking his mind. His positions as a House member in the 1980s against pay raises and pensions drew the ire of his colleagues at that time. Today, he leads a group working to reform Pennsylvania state government, and he has no hesitation about sharing what goes through some lawmakers' minds when they ghost vote.
So what's the big deal if I go to the back and have a sandwich and a cup of coffee and I put my clip in the no position, or I tell Charlie, vote me no if we had final passage? They don't view that as the end of the world. It's just a signal that there's a disrespect for the process.
While it is against the House's own rules, ghost voting is not illegal. Kennedy describes it as somewhat of a necessary evil, saying nearly all House members ghost vote at one point or another, maybe to step away during voting to use the restroom or to speak with reporters. But some take it to an extreme.
It is pretty cavalier because this is not the way the framers ever thought that our elected representatives would be operating.
Marcy Hamilton is a law professor who has studied ghost voting in Pennsylvania's General Assembly. Beyond bathroom breaks, she says some lawmakers rig their voting buttons and never even travel to Harrisburg on voting days.
They don't seem to be concerned about accountability on this particular issue. And it's a little odd you wouldn't be concerned about it when it's the final decision on whether a law is passed or not.
One of the most talked about ghost votes happened in 1991 when Philadelphia Democrat Richard Hayden cast the deciding vote on the controversial state budget that year. The problem? The vote took place while Hayden was waiting to board a plane in Philadelphia, bound for his Hawaiian vacation. Reporters uncovered Hayden used a paperclip to rig his voting button, so he was recorded as a yes. Because of limited access to the House floor, we weren't able to check every seat. But our camera did recently find 3 rigged voting buttons, all belonging to lawmakers from the Philadelphia region, Democrats Michael McGeehan and Babette Josephs, and Republican Robert Godshaw.
These are such archaic systems that you can't possibly rig it to vote yes on the first bill, no on the next bill, yes on the next bill. So they have, if they're not going to be there, they have to choose to vote all yes on all of the bills and all no on all of the bills. And that means they are not doing what they're elected to do.
Ghost voting also opens the door to another problem. Because House lawmakers are required to be present to vote, a lawmaker's voting record is considered proof of his or her attendance. So on the same day a lawmaker rigs the voting system and never comes to the Capitol, he or she could still collect money for travel expenses, about $150 a day at taxpayers' expense, known as a per diem.
If that casting of the vote is being used as evidence that they should get a per diem, that's troubling. There's something wrong with that system.
Of the 3 lawmakers we connected to rigged voting buttons, only one, Republican Robert Godshaw, responded to our questions about why. And while he didn't deny using a nickel to rig his voting button, Godshaw says he was not ghost voting. He wrote to me in an email saying, quote, "I am in the House chamber during votes. Sometimes we meet with constituents in the back of the chamber, other members as well. Thus, we sometimes have to leave our desks." But therein lies the problem. There is a huge difference between rigging your voting button and stepping away for a few moments and doing that and then not coming to Harrisburg at all. And under this current system, it's very difficult to distinguish who was doing what.